Hurry up! September is almost over! And you know what's next? Hacktober! First of all, what is Hacktoberfest? It's not an anonymous hacking anniversary, but rather a global event that aims to raise awareness to open source and encourage as many developers as possible to participate, not just in October, but throughout the entire year. Hacktoberfest also comes with a challenge. The first 40,000 participants will be eligible for one between two prizes: the official Hacktoberfest 2022 t-shirt or a tree planted in their names. The goal of the challenge is quite simple. You have to complete 4 pull requests, respecting some criteria. If you're interested in how to participate, I'll tell you how. Oh right, an addition from this very year is that contributions without code count as well. So not only developers can participate, but really everyone. And by the way, open source is also the main topic of this very YouTube channel. So I'm just saying, if you want to subscribe, you might be interested by the other content I share regularly. Now let's get to the juicy part. You want to participate, right? Well, there are mainly two actors to this competition. Contributors, that is, who writes code to someone else's repository, and maintainers, who are the owners and maintainers of the repositories and allow contributors to open pull requests and flag them as valid. So let me explain the rules. First of all, you need to be registered. You can register from the official website from Monday 26th of September all the way until the end of October, so there's really no hurry to register. Rule number two is that the PR has to be submitted either on GitHub, the most popular platform, or GitLab, and during the month of October, so September pull request will not count. Speaking of the repository, it obviously has to be public, and the owner or the maintainers have to accept your PR by adding the Hacktoberfest accepted label, or the repository must have the Hacktoberfest topic. And wait, what are repository topics? I also didn't know, so let me show you. You can just find them here. Beware, do not try to fool the system with spammy or irrelevant pull requests, because maintainers can add the flag invalid or spam, and not only your PR will not count, but you might only get disqualified for this year. You better follow the rules and use this event for its original purpose, that is, contributing to open source, and not just winning the t-shirt or winning a prize. Open source is the prize, what you learn. So, we just said how to participate by contributing. Let's now analyze how to participate if you have a repository and you're looking for contributors. First of all, try to think like a contributor who's maybe in his first experience on GitHub or on open source, so you want to guide them through all the process. This means make sure you have an up-to-date readme.md, contributing.md in your root folder, and also you have issues that are well explained, maybe with screenshots, and don't forget about code pointers. Those are really useful for new users coming to your repository. And also, another good practice you might already know is adding the right labels. So, good first issue, help wanted, up for grabs. If you're a maintainer of a project, you should already know, but I just gave you a little reminder. Basically, those suggestions apply even outside the Hacktoberfest. You want a repository to be user-friendly to attract new contributors. But don't forget that the first rule is to have fun. I mean, after all, we all contribute for many reasons, but it doesn't have to be boring, right? Keep in mind that maintainers can participate actively as well, and they might receive a reward kit from the Hacktoberfest organization. Just keep in mind that those kits are limited, so it's not as easy as completing 4 pull requests, and the organizer will get in touch with you if you're eligible. The 4 actions are merging a pull request, providing an approving review for a PR, adding the Hacktoberfest accepted label, or the spam or invalid labels, to make sure spammy PRs are not counted. To make sure a PR counts, don't forget the Hacktoberfest accepted label or the topic in the repository. We just saw a few minutes ago how to add the topic, so you can get back on the video. Oh, it's the other side because I'm mirrored. Get back on the video. You're not a developer? Fear not, because like I said, starting from this year, you can count with no-code contributions like writing documentation, translating documentation, or even blog posts, videos, articles. Just make sure to get in touch with the maintainers of the repository so that they can organize a list and you can open a pull request, maybe with the link of your resource. This is required so that your PR can be automatically be counted, otherwise it will just get lost. With that said, you now know all rules you need to participate to Hacktoberfest, but in case you still need to find a repository, well, look at this video, I'll tell you a quick way to find a repository that you can count for Hacktoberfest. You'll find some practical steps to make this quest way easier and you get closer to winning the t-shirt. Hit like on this video and see you there!